If you're looking to get yourself a new EDC knife and you've got around $50 to spend, you clicked on the right video because today I've got 10 different EDC knives and you really don't have to spend all that much to get yourself a good quality knife that will last you a really long time. And we're going to be taking a look at each one and discussing their specs and features so you can decide which one is best for you. We're going to kick things off with the new Mamba V2 from QSP. And this is going to be one of the best options if you want a relatively long mid-sized knife with an incredible looking design. It has a tip-up deep carry style pocket clip, and this version has a really nice and soft black micarta handle and a small loop on the end for attaching a lanyard. You can open the Mamba V2 with the flipper tab, and it has ceramic bearings, so the action is incredibly smooth, and it's held in place with the liner locking mechanism. The Mamba has a drop point blade shape with a flat grind, which is very durable and a versatile shape, and it's made from D2, which is a good budget-friendly steel, and it has a black stonewash finish. And it's definitely one of the longer blades in the lineup, coming in at about 3.5 inches. There's some jimping on the spine and a groove for your index finger. And overall, it feels like a very well balanced and impressive knife, and it looks really excellent. You can pick up the Mamba V2 for around $59. No budget knife roundup video would be complete without Civivi, and this is the Odium. And this is actually a collaboration from them and Ferrum Forge Knifeworks. And it's a great option if you're looking for a more compact and lightweight option. It has a very small removable black pocket clip and textured and contoured gray G10 handle scales, which are very smooth. You get a few options for deployment, including a large thumb hole and a very small flipper tab, and it's very fast and it rides on bronze pivot washers and secured with the liner lock. The Odium has a drop point blade shape with a flat grind, and it's made from D2 steel with a nice stonewashed finish. There's a considerable amount of jimping on the spine and also on the liner lock, which contacts with your index finger. And even though it's a smaller knife, it actually is a great fit for my hands, and all of my fingers fit on the blade quite comfortably. And you can pick this up at Blade HQ for $52.70. Another great option from Civivi is the Brazen. And this knife is considerably larger than the Odium, and it's a great option if you're looking for a tactical style knife for heavy duty use. This version has black G10 handle scales, but you can pick it up in a ton of different colors as well as micarta. You also get multiple options to deploy the blade, either by using thumb studs, or you can use the flipper tab. And the action on this knife is really snappy with pivot bearings, and probably the best in the lineup. The Brazen has a liner lock and a Tanto shaped blade, but you can also pick it up in a drop point, and it's made from D2 and has a black finish. There's some jimping on the spine, and it has very comfortable finger grooves, which help you get an excellent grip on this knife. And overall, it's a very simple and great looking tactical knife, and you can pick one up for $49.30 at Blade HQ, which is an excellent deal. Next up, we have the medium flipper from Honey Badger Knives, who are based in Southern California. And this is one of the most affordable knives in the lineup, and it's also made in the USA. It has a removable tip-up deep carry style pocket clip, and the handle is black, and has a really nice honeycomb pattern, which feels excellent to grip, and it's resistant to slipping even when it gets wet, and it's made from fiber reinforced nylon. One thing that's really cool about Honey Badger Knives is that they sell different handle colors, backspacers, and pocket clips, so you can easily customize the look of your knife. You can deploy this knife with the thumb hole or with the flipper tab, which is bearing driven, and the action is very quick and smooth, and it has a liner locking mechanism. This is a drop point shaped blade made from 8CR13 MOV steel, which is a budget-friendly steel that's easy to sharpen, and it has a flat grind and a nice satin finish. There's some jimping on the handle and the spine, and also on the grooves for your middle and index fingers. And overall, the feel is excellent in the hand. You can pick up this knife from Honey Badger's website for $37, and the handle sets start at about $9. The next knife is the Kubey Wolverine, and this is a great option if you're in the market for a really sleek and sturdy EDC knife that's comfortable to hold. This one has a beautiful ivory-covered handle made from G10, but you can also pick it up in a handful of other colors, and there's also a removable pocket clip. There's a flipper tab with some jimping, which you can use to deploy the blade, and it rides on cage ceramic bearings, and the action is definitely one of the smoothest in the lineup, and it also has a liner lock. The Wolverine has a drop point shaped blade with a flat grind, and it's made from D2 steel, and this one has a dark stonewash finish, which provides a really nice contrast to the ivory handle. There's some jimping on the spine and a nice deep groove for your index finger, and for me, it does feel like one of the most comfortable knives in the lineup to hold. The Kubey Wolverine is available on Amazon and AliExpress for $50 at the time of making this video. And overall, I think it's one of the best all-around blades in the lineup. I've got another knife here from Kubey, and this is the Cadmus. And this is a great option if you're looking for a lightweight mid-sized knife at a reasonable price point. This one has a jade handle made from G10, but you can also pick it up in black and gray. And there's also a removable pocket clip. There's a flipper tab with some jimping, which you can use to deploy the blade, and it rides on cage ceramic bearings. And the action is quite smooth, and it has a liner lock. The Cadmus also has a drop point shaped blade with a flat grind, and it's made from D2 steel with a nice satin finish, but you can also pick it up in Chinese Damascus. There's some jimping on the spine and some ergonomic grooves for your fingers, and overall it does feel pretty comfortable to carry. The Kubey Cadmus is available on Amazon and AliExpress for $40 at the time of making this video, and overall I think it's a pretty good knife considering the price. This is the Warden 2 Tanto from Revo Knives, and this is a great option if you're looking for a slim knife with a long Tanto style blade. The handle has black G10 scales on steel liners, and has a tip-up carry pocket clip that's removable and reversible. You can deploy the blade with a flipper tab, and the action is really snappy and smooth, and is hands down the quickest out of all the knives in the lineup. And it also has a liner lock to secure the blade in place. The Revo Warden 2 has a Tanto blade made of 9CR18 MOV steel, which is actually a pretty decent mid-range steel with great edge retention, and it's got a flat grind and a stonewash finish. There's some jimping on the spine and a liner lock and a bit of jimping for your index finger as well. And overall, the feel is quite good in the hands. You can pick up this knife from Blade HQ for $49.99. This is the Kiridashi from Cold Steel. And this is a great option if you're looking for something affordable with a great lock and a more utilitarian design. It has a really wide pocket clip, which is really nice because it actually helps you get a much better grip on the knife when it's open, and it has a black handle made from reinforced nylon. You can deploy the blade with the thumb studs, and the action is a bit stiffer than many of the other knives here, but it does have a triad locking mechanism, which is really safe, and it's an incredibly strong lock. The Kiridashi has a sheep's foot shaped blade with a flat grind, and is made from 4116 stainless steel, which is a low-end steel, but it does offer excellent corrosion resistance. The spine is smooth, but overall it feels good in the hands, and this design is pretty non-threatening and discreet, which is good if you don't want to draw too much attention to yourself, and this knife is available at Blade HQ for $36.54. Next up, we've got the SOG Aegis FLK, and this is a great option if you're looking for a pocket knife that's really large and good for heavy-duty use, and it's also one of the most affordable options in the lineup. The handle is made from stainless steel, and it's got a tip-up deep carry style pocket clip. It has a nice big kick style flipper tab, and the deployment is pretty smooth, and this is a frame lock knife. The Aegis FLK has a spear point blade, which excels at stabbing, and it's made from 8CR13 MOV steel, and it's got a flat grind and a stonewash finish. There's some jimping on the spine, and also some jimping for your index and middle finger, and you can actually get a really good grip on this knife, which is great if you plan to use it for more aggressive tasks. You can pick up the Aegis FLK from Blade HQ for $24.99, which makes it the most budget-friendly option in the lineup. This is the Blue Ridge Knives Esee Zancudo, and this is a good option if you want a very affordable entry-level knife from a company that has a great reputation for knife making. This version has a desert tan G10 front handle and a black stainless steel back, but you can also pick it up in a ton of different colors, and it also has a removable pocket clip. You can use thumb studs to deploy the blade, and it has a frame lock. The Zancudo has a drop point blade shape with a flat grind, and it's made from AUS 8 steel, which is an entry-level steel that's great if you're just getting into knives, and this one has a nice black EDP coating. There's a tiny bit of jimping on the spine, and a nice indent for your index finger, and even though this knife is on the skinnier side, it does feel good to hold, and the pocket clip definitely enhances the grip considerably. At the time of making this video, you can pick up this knife for $34.18 on Amazon, which definitely makes it one of the most affordable knives in the lineup. Thanks so much for watching the video, and if you enjoyed it, check out my $100 and under EDC knife video, which is linked to down below as well. And don't forget to comment down below and let us know which of these knives is your favorite. And if there's another knife that you like that's around $50, you can share that down below as well.